Okay, so let's start with section D. In the earlier video, I have completed section C, and now it's a time for discussion of section D, which is cost management. In totality, I have included 6 cases, which we are going to learn here. Okay, chalo, now start with case number 16. True Jeans, a new startup company, plans to produce blue jeans pants, customized with the buyer's name first stitched across the back pocket. जींस पे तुम्हारा नाम लिखा होगा. द प्रोडक्ट विल बी मार्क्ड एक्सक्लूसिवली वाया इंटरनेट वेबसाइट फॉर द कमिंग ईयर. सेल्स हैव बीन प्रोजेक्टेड एट 3 डिफरेंट लेवल, ऑप्टिमिस्टिक, न्यूट्रल एंड पेसिमिस्टिक. ट्रू जींस डज नॉट कीप इन्वेंट्री ऑन द हैंड बट प्रिफर मिनिमाइजिंग दिस इन्वेस्टमेंट. मतलब ये देख के पता चल रहा है जस्ट इन टाइम का कुछ कॉन्सेप्ट है इसका. The controller is preparing assemble the budget for the coming year, is unsure about the number of issues including the following: the level of sell to enter into the budget, how much sales I will be requiring, how to allocate the significant fixed cost to the individual units. Ye uska concern hai. Whether to use job order costing or the process costing. Theek hai, chalo ek ek karke answer dete hain. In addition, the controller has a heard of a Kaizen budgeting and wondering if such approach could be used to Trojans. Kaizen, continuous improvement. Okay. Kya hota? First question, what he is asking. How the controller use expected value approach to set the sales level up for the budget? What is additional information would be needed? सबसे पहला expected sales आपको पता है probability के basis पे होता है. ओके, सो यहाँ पे थियोरेटिकल एक आंसर दिया है. लेट्स चेक क्या है. द सेल्स स्टाफ हैज नॉट प्रेजेंटेड द कंट्रोलर विद अ यूनिक एक्सपेक्टेड यूनिट ऑफ सेल्स बट रादर सेल्स नंबर्स अंडर वेरियस सिनेरियोस. द कंट्रोलर यूज एक्सपेक्टेड सेल्स इन अ बजट विच इज समेशन ऑफ द एंटिसिपेटेड सेल्स अंडर ईच सिनेरियो टाइम्स द प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ दैट सिनेरियो विच आई हैव टोल्ड यू. ओके, सिंस यू आर अ पार्ट वन स्टूडेंट तो आपको पता होगा प्रोबेबिलिटी एनालिसिस क्या होता है. The controller would need to estimate the probability of each scenario in order to complete the task. मैंने आपको पहले ही बोला था, फिर से बोल रहा हूँ. This is question based on probability. चलो. How could the variable direct costing mitigate the problem? How to allocate the fixed cost to individual units? सबसे पहली बात, variable costing में, if you know, marginal costing में मैंने जैसा आपको बोला है, तो उसमें मैं क्या करता हूँ, whether it is manufacturing or non-manufacturing, मुझे पूरा का पूरा fixed cost एक साथ में लिख देना पड़ता है, okay? Under the direct costing, fixed manufacturing costs are expensed rather than adding to inventory each cost of unit. Thus, it is not necessary to determine allocation of fixed cost to the individual units. जैसा मैंने आपको पहले बताया था, आपको सबका सब कॉस्ट वहां पर डालना पड़ता. विच कॉस्ट सिस्टम सीम्स मोर मेक सेंस टू जींस, जॉब ऑर्डर कॉस्टिंग और द प्रोसेस कॉस्टिंग. ओके, आंसर बहुत अच्छा दिया है, ध्यान से पढ़ना. देखो, एट अ फर्स्ट ग्लांस जॉब ऑर्डर कॉस्टिंग अपीयर्स मोर सेंस. जितना ज्यादा आएगा मटेरियल उतना ज्यादा मैं ऑर्डर करके दूंगा. लिटरली यूनिक, ईच पेयर ऑफ जींस इज लिटरली यूनिक बिकॉज कस्टमर का नाम उस पर छपा है. Given that a buyer name is stitched on a back pocket, however, in reality, process costing should be used because jeans will be produced continuously and the cost purpose will be same for each pair. Sabka process same to same hone wala hai. Okay, that's the end of case number 16. Hello. I think there is some number issue. This was 16 and it should be 18, but I have written 18. ओके, इट्स फाइन. चलो, केस नंबर 18, सॉरी केस नंबर 16, केस नंबर 18. मेनी कंपनीज रिकॉग्नाइजेस दैट कॉस्ट सिस्टम आर इनएडिक्वेट टुडेज पावरफुल ग्लोबल कंपटीशन. मैनेजर्स इन अ कंपनी सेलिंग मल्टीपल प्रोडक्ट्स आर मेकिंग इंपॉर्टेंट प्रोडक्ट डिसीजन बेस्ड ऑन अ डिसऑर्डर्ड कॉस्ट इन्फॉर्मेशन एज मोस्ट कॉस्ट सिस्टम डिजाइन पास्ट फोकस ऑन द इन्वेंटरी वैल्यूएशन. In order to evaluate the level of management information, it has been suggested that companies would have many 3 cost system: inventory valuation, management control of operation, activity based costing system for the decision making. Kaun sa inventory valuation, management control and activity based costing for the decision making. Okay, चलो three cost system बोला, एक normal सा case तुमको दिया था. Discuss why traditional cost system developed to the value inventory, distort cost product information. पहले तो एक चीज बताता हूँ, इसमें एक ही लेवल लेके आपको अलोकेट सब कॉस्ट करना पड़ता है. यू हैव टू अलोकेट ईच एंड एवरी एलिमेंट बाय टेकिंग वन बेस. ओके, तो उससे क्या होता है, प्रोडक्ट का वैल्यूएशन प्रॉपरली नहीं हो पाता. ओके, सो द वी विल रीड द आंसर. द ट्रेडिशनल कॉस्ट सिस्टम डेवलप्ड वैल्यू इन्वेंट्री डिस्टॉर्ट प्रोडक्शन कॉस्ट इन्फॉर्मेशन बिकॉज कॉस्ट सिस्टम वॉज डिजाइन टू वैल्यू इन्वेंट्री इन एग्रीगेट नॉट रिलेटेड टू प्रोडक्ट कॉस्ट इन्फॉर्मेशन. दिस कॉस्ट इज नॉट रिलेटेड टू द प्रोडक्ट. जो भी टोटल कॉस्ट आया उसको किसी भी प्रोडक्ट पर उठा के डाल दिया. यूजेस कॉमन डिपार्टमेंटल फैक्ट्री वाइड मेजर्स ऑफ एक्टिविटी सच एज डायरेक्ट लेबर आवर और डॉलर्स नॉ स्मॉल प्रपोर्शन ऑफ ओवरऑल प्रोडक्शन कॉस्ट टू डिस्ट्रीब्यूट मैन्युफैक्चरिंग ओवरहेड ऑफ प्रोडक्ट्स. डी इम्फेसिस लॉन्ग टर्म प्रोडक्ट एनालिसिस व्हेन फिक्स्ड कॉस्ट बिकम वेरिएबल कॉस्ट. ओके, मतलब लॉन्ग टर्म पर्सपेक्टिव है नहीं, इस साल जितना कॉस्ट आया उसको अलोकेट कर दिया. Causes managers who were aware of distortion traditional system to make intuitive imprecise adjustment traditional cost information without understanding the complete impact. कुछ भी allocate हो जाता है, distort हो जाता है and without understanding the impact. मैंने हर बार जब भी whenever you had solved some example in PICS I have solved many sums on comparison of ABC versus variable costing. Okay. No, sorry, variable versus traditional. And we have found out that there is a certain gaps because traditional costing system does not allocate cost properly. Okay? So the same thing they are saying over here. 4 points. Chal, next. Identify the purpose and the characteristic of each of the following. Inventory valuation, management control operation and activity based costing. Now let's check what is this. Outline below are the purpose characteristics of the three noted cost system. First one, inventory valuation. Let me highlight the first all the things. Okay. Meeting external reporting requirement for aggregate between balance sheet valuation and the income determination. Provide monthly and quarterly reporting inventory valuation because since you have to value your inventory based on FIFO, LIFO, or it is VAM. Okay. Management control of operation. Evaluating operations in order to quickly detect problems to allow implementation of a corrective actions. Comparing cost against budget for the monitoring. It's very simple based on management control. Activity based costing, differentiating cost between value adding and non value adding activities. We have learned this in while we have reading the theory. Second, costing product according to activities involved in a production process. Okay, first, second, differentiating cost between value adding and non value adding activities. Second, costing product according to activities involved in a production process. What are the cost you have incurred while production? Okay. Chalo. Describe the benefit that management can expect from activity based costing. This is the most important question. Trust me guys, if you are getting essay questions from section D, this question will be there 100%. They are going to ask this question. Second, list the step that company using traditional cost system would take implement activity based costing. Means why ABC you will choose over traditional costing. Simple. Chalo. First we will see the benefits of ABC. Let's check that. Chalo. Third. So we are going to check the benefits of ABC. Benefits of ABC. The benefits that management can expect from an activity-based costing include the following. Leads to more competitive position by evaluating cost drivers. Example, cost associated with the complexities of the transaction rather than production volume. means they focus on cost. Streamline process by reducing non-value adding activities, example reduce setup time, optimal plant layout, improved quality. Provides management with a more understanding of a product cost and period cost. Product cost and product profitability for the strategies and the pricing decisions. Provides management with the more through the thorough understanding of a product cost and the product profitability for the strategies and the pricing decisions. Okay? Chalo. Come on next. The step that company using traditional cost system would take implement activity-based costing include the following. Evaluation of existing system to assess how well the system supports the objective of an activity-based costing. Means the first question you will have to ask, why ABC required? If you do not have any problem with the existing system, then why you are changing to ABC? Identification the activities for which cost information is needed with a differentiation between value adding and non-value adding activities. Now, trust me, you need cost object also, cost object, cost drivers, okay? And after that, you need to decide also which cost are adding value adding and non-value adding things you need to check. Adding things you need to check. Hope you will understand this. Okay? Chalo. Let's move to next case. Case 18. That was 17. Now we are coming to 18. Chalo. Let's check that. Inmam Inc. is a manufacturer of a single product and is starting to develop budget for the coming year. Because cost of goods manufactured is the biggest item, Inmam's senior management reviewing how costs are calculated. In addition, senior management wants to develop budgeting system that motivates managers and other workers to work towards the corporate goals. Inmam has incurred the following cost to make 1 lakh units during the month of September. Material diya, direct labor, variable overheads, this is variable selling, fixed manufacturing and fixed selling admin. Ye dekh ke pata chal raha hai ki boss bahut sara cheez karna hai. Product cost and period cost ka sum puchta, then you know what you have to do. Inmam Inc. September 1 inventory consists of 10,000 units valued at 72,000. Okay, using absorption costing. Can I say it is opening of finished goods? Total fixed cost and variable cost per unit have not changed during the past few months. Kuch bhi change nahi hua. Okay. Isne total fixed cost bolta change nahi hua and variable cost per unit change nahi hua. Even you know ki ye hamesha same hi hota at all the levels. Okay. Sorry. Relevant range. Sorry to use this word. We have to use relevant range. In September, Inmam sold 1,06,000 units at 12 per unit. Okay. Using absorption costing, calculate the following. Inmam's September manufacturing cost per unit, Inmam's 30th inventory value, Inmam's September net income. Come. Whatever. We will not waste in the time to solve this kind of things. So I'm just going to give you a brief on this. You have to add material, labor, variable manufacturing overheads and fixed manufacturing. All the manufacturing expenses you need to add. Manufacturing expenses you need to add. Okay. The total came to 7,20,000. So 7,20,000 divided by 1 lakh, that is 7.2 per unit. Now you need to tell me what is 1 lakh. What is 1 lakh? Cost to make 1000 units. Okay. Number of units produced. Number of units produced. Hope you understood this. Aage. Now he is asking 30th September inventory value. Now, if you know this calculation per unit, then it will be very simple. So now what you need to do? Opening, add manufactured minus sold, 4000 units. Okay, so 4000 units is your closing stock. Closing stock multiplied by the rate. So 4000 multiplied by 7.2, it's coming to 28,800. That is your closing inventory valuation. Closing finished goods value. Okay. Now I have calculated this on the number of units produced. Number of units produced. Net income I need to check on the basis of sold. Okay? They are just asking net income. So if you calculate the entire profit and loss statement, what you might be doing, 106,000 multiplied by 12, which is selling price. Now you need to calculate cost of goods sold. And even you know, cost of goods sold means opening inventory add cost of goods manufactured minus closing inventory. And you have all the cost. COGS came to 760,200. So 1272 was your sales. That is your sales minus cost of goods sold, which came to 763,200. Now you need to check gross profit. So 1272 minus 763,200. 508,800. Selling and admin expense. Okay, so now even you had taken suno abhi aapke mind mein ye aa raha hai ki boss manufacturing cost kida gaya, to obviously ye cost of goods manufactured mein hi aa gaya na. To abhi baki hai whatever is your non product cost. So I can say the total non product cost will be 380,000, which is inclusive of 80,000 variable cost and 300,000 fixed cost. So now this is total coming to 508,800 minus 380,000, 128,800. 128,800 is your net income. Next question, what they are asking. Sorry. Now they are asking, using variable costing, calculate the following. Same thing they are asking again and again. Okay, now even you know variable costing doesn't differentiate between variable and fixed, manufacturing and non-manufacturing. Okay, now come here. Cost to manufacture 1 lakh units, 4 lakh material, direct labor, variable overheads. Okay. Understand my point, they have just taken variable overheads. Okay, notice one thing, only variable overheads. So now my inventory value is 4000 units. I have calculated sum mein diya tha, and 5.2 per units. Abhi sir, 5.2 units kahan se aaya? Simple, 520,000 divided by 1 lakh. This is 5.2 per unit. Your inventory valuation is 2800. Now they are asking about net income. Okay, and even you know, isme jitna bhi cost hota hai, sab aapko nikal ke dena hai. Theek hai? So now simple thing which you need to do, sales minus variable cost. So I will take sales, which is 106,000 multiplied by 12. Here I need to take manufacturing cost and selling and admin cost. And I have told you again and again that whenever you are going to solve the sum based on variable costing, you should always take number of units sold. Always take number of units sold. Okay, so manufacturing cost will be 106,000 multiplied by 5.2. here 106. अच्छा दे हैड ऑलरेडी गिवन 80,000 सो वी डोंट नीड टू कैलकुलेट सो 1,06,000 इनटू 12 इक्वल टू दिस विल बी 1,272 1,272,000 एंड 5.2 5.2 जिस 551,200 एंड सेलिंग एंड एडमिन 80,000 सो इफ यू विल कैलकुलेट दिस यू विल गेट कंट्रीब्यूशन मार्जिन ओके कंट्रीब्यूशन मार्जिन विल बी 172,000 एक सेकेंड व्हाट आई एम डूइंग कंट्रीब्यूशन मार्जिन विल बी लेट्स कैलकुलेट 1,272,000 551,200 माइनस 80,000 6,40,800 नाउ इवन यू नो दैट हियर आई नीड टू टेक बोथ द फिक्स कॉस्ट ओके सो 2,00,000 प्लस 3,00,000 द टोटल विल बी 7,00,000 रुपीज एक सेकेंड 2,00,000 3,00,000 टोटल इज 5,00,000 टोटल इज 5,00,000 यू नीड टू डिडक्ट सो नाउ योर नेट इनकम विल बी 1,40,800 1,40,800 ओके चलो लेट्स गो टू थर्ड Identify and explain one reason why income included in the previous two questions might differ. Normally, you should always say treatment of fixed cost. That's it. And you always and in traditional method, okay, not traditional. I can say in normal costing method, what you take entire thing based on manufacturing and non-manufacturing. Means you. Focus on manufacturing and non-manufacturing activities. But in variable costing, you focus on fixed and variable thing. Okay? Chalo, so let's read this. And it is important also. The difference in the income is caused by treatment of fixed manufacturing overheads. Absorption costing. Treat this cost as a product cost that is held in an inventory until the goods are sold. Okay, that's why if you notice, we always take goods produced as a base, not sold. Variable costing treat fixed manufacturing overhead as a period costing, would expense all the current month's fixed manufacturing overhead as well as some costs were previously deferred to the prior period's inventory. Variable costing will only expense out current months resulting a higher income. Okay, means majorly the entire expenses rooted to profit and loss, and they don't treat inventory cost as an inventoryable cost. Okay, so majorly variable costing focus on P&L basis and absorption costing focus on balance sheet approach. Okay, chalo, good. Fourth, now what they are asking, identify and discuss one advantage of each of the following: absorption and variable. First of all, you need to remember that absorption costing is useful for the financial reporting purpose. Okay, please be aware of that. The advantage of using absorption costing are: it is required for the external reporting. It matches all manufacturing cost with the revenues. Matlab, it allows matching concept. Natural si baat hai boss. If it is for financial reporting purpose, usme ye matching concept hona hi usko dikhana hi padega. Now see, there are lots of advantage of variable costing. Data required for CVP analysis, which is marginal costing, can be taken directly from the statement on the spot. Jo bhi hai usko utha lenega. The profit for the period is not affected by change in inventories, because इसमें inventory का कुछ काम ही नहीं होता. Unit product cost do not contain fixed cost. Do not contain fixed cost. Not fixed cost. That are often utilized. Practice that could result in poor decision making. The impact of fixed cost is a profit is emphasized because they take all the fixed cost. It is easier to estimate the product's profitability. It ties with the cost control measures such as flexible budget, because flexible budget is completely is one of the type of variable costing. Chalo. Now, next point. Next, they are asking, identify one strength and one weakness of authoritative budgeting and participative budgeting. Authoritative, top to down. Participative, down to up. Which of this budgeting method will work best in Monk Inc? Explain your answer. Identify and explain one method top managers can take to restrict the production managers from the taking advantage of budgetary slack. Budgetary slack, you know what? Revenue kya kiya, kam kiya, and cost bada diya. Advantage of authoritative top-down budgeting. Speed control. Disadvantage of authoritative top-down budgeting. Little buy-in. Senior management has less information than lower manager. Advantage of participative bottom-to-up. More likely to commit. Disadvantage. Must set easier target. Agar low level ka banda bolega mujhe sirf 1 lakh units hi bechna hai. But manager bolta hai, no boss, you need to achieve at least 1,50,000. Best authoritative top-down cost product most important, want to focus on the control. Benchmarking with the outside examples, mutual learning about the problems, balance scorecard, methods of a evaluation. Ye answer C ka tha. Budgetary slack ko kaise kam karne ga? Benchmarking se karo. Mutual learning, balance scorecard, evaluation. Okay. Now we will go on next. Okay, before starting this, let me tell you, we don't have this reconciliation in your portion. Okay, so I'm just cancelling it. Chalo. Now let's read this case number 19. Case 19. Barton Industries process chemicals for the pharmaceutical industry. Wiley Richardson, a company president, was eager to see operating result for just completed fiscal years. He believed that changes that were made during the year would result in increased profit, as an expected sales volume of 1 million kg at the beginning of the year in response to 10% increase in production cost. The sales price has been increased 12%. And the selling and admin department have given strict instruction to hold expenses at the same level in the previous year. Okay, means don't increase your expenditures. Therefore, Richard R. was demurred to learn that the net income has dropped despite of achieving the planned increase in the sales volume. Show below are the comparative operating income statement for Barton Industries for the last 2 years, along with the budgeted operating and the financial data. This year's cost of goods sold includes adjustment of fixed overhead cost where under applied. Ye important hai. Ek under applied bhi tha, usko bhi usne dal ke rakha isme. Actual result were the same as a budget, except for the production volume. The company uses first in first out inventory valuation method and has an ending inventory of 4,50,000 kgs this year. Okay? Chalo. Good. We have this kind of statement with us. Sales diya, cost of goods diya, selling operating income diya. Then, budgeted operating and financial data. That is comparative operating statement, income statement in summarized form. And this is completely a financial data. Okay, now let us understand beginning inventory and production volume. Explain why Barton Industries' operating income decreased in the fiscal year despite of sales price and sales volume increases. Okay, so we don't have that much of time to discuss insight of this, so I'm just going to answer. Production was less than the budget. Fixed overheads were under applied. So naturally profit hi dikhega na agar under applied hua. This caused unfavorable volume variances was charged to cost of goods sold, increasing expenses and decreasing operating income. अगर मैंने under applied कोई भी चीज़ अगर COGS में charge कर दिया तो natural सी बात है COGS में मेरा cost increase ही होने वाला है. Okay? चलो next. Prepare an operating income statement for the current fiscal year for the Barton using the variable direct costing method. Okay? So variable costing क्या आएगा? Sales minus variable cost. Okay? सब कुछ दिया. आ जाओ. So let's see here. Variable cost this much at 5.5 inventory and this is for the completely production. Now this you got contribution margin and the total fixed cost you need to deduct, which you had done here. Okay, so the net income you got, that is 1200. Theek hai? Chalo, good. Okay, so now if you noticing that where you got this 4 lakh units, so this production volume includes 10 lakh me se. If you notice 6 lakh mera opening ka tha production jo maine kiya and 4 lakhs was my closing units. Okay, good. Third, we are not doing this. Identify two advantage and two disadvantage of using variable direct costing method for the internal reporting. Yes, it is useful for internal reporting. Advantage of variable costing for the internal reporting. Aids in reporting and forecasting contribution margin. Obviously, apna direct costing method mein ya to absorption costing method mein na kahin bhi contribution margin nahi aata. Okay, but in variable costing technique, we always get contribution margin. Because fixed cost are the period cost, they are more predictable and controllable. Yes, profit vary with the direct sales volume and the unaffected by the inventory changes. Inventory mein jo change karna hai karo, because we don't take closing inventory in our consideration. Kyunki we always calculate entire thing on sales. Ads CVP analysis can determine break even point. एंड इवन यू नो मैंने छोटा सा एक चीज बताया था ब्रेक इवन पॉइंट यू विल लर्न इन पार्ट टू बट मैंने इस चैप्टर में भी सिखाया था ब्रेक इवन पॉइंट फिक्स कॉस्ट डिवाइड बाय कंट्रीब्यूशन पर यूनिट ओके नाउ व्हाट आर द डिसएडवांटेज फिक्स कॉस्ट मे बी ओवरलुक्ड एज अ पार्ट ऑफ डिसीजन मेकिंग प्रोसेस इसमें पता है वी ऑल्सो कंसिडर नॉन मैन्युफैक्चरिंग फिक्स कॉस्ट ऑल्सो तो वो थोड़ा डिसएडवांटेज होता है लैक्स एक्सेप्टेबिलिटी फॉर द एक्सटर्नल रिपोर्टिंग cannot be used as a basis for the income tax calculation. Sometimes distinction between fixed and variable cost is arbitrary. समझ में नहीं आता है कौन सा fixed है कौन सा variable है ठीक है case number 20 we are learning. Zoos would design produces customized textiles such as dresses, formal attire and uniforms. Rosewood is a small sole proprietorship owned and managed by the Samuel Wood. Rosewood uses job order costing system. During July, Rosewood completed job number 431 and order of 2000 school uniforms. Based on the success of larger order, Wood is contemplating the drastic change in a business strategy. Wood is considering mass producing school uniforms and gradually phasing out customer orders. Relevant financial information shown below. Okay, job 431 has an opening work in progress inventory balance 33,000 on the July 1. During 3,000 of direct material was added on a job. Job 431 requires a total 3,500 direct labor hours with a 1 hour of those taking place in July. Okay, 2,500 baad mein lega. The average labor rate for the production worker is 7 per hour. Rosewood completed 431 on the July 25th. Rosewood predetermined manufacturing overhead rate is at 3 rupees direct labor hour. ओके ये मैन्युफैक्चरिंग रेट है ऊपर वाला लेबर का रेट था आफ्टर कंप्लीटिंग जॉब 431 मैनेजमेंट एनालाइज द डायरेक्ट लेबर आवर्स रोजवुड नॉर्मली एक्सपीरियंस अ 80% लर्निंग कर्व एंड मैनेजमेंट एक्सपेक्ट दैट लर्निंग कर्व विल लेवल आफ्टर प्रोड्यूसिंग 8000 यूनिफॉर्म ओके मतलब उसके बाद सेटल हो जाएगा Define and explain job costing system Rosewood currently uses. Rosewood current job order costing system used for the custom unique production where the cost of a each job can be traced directly to the unique order. जो order आ रहा है उससे मैं trace कर रहा हूँ because हर एक का job order का number C, हर एक का job order अपना अपना number है जैसे यहाँ पे 431 था ठीक है Identify what costing system would be most suitable if the Rosewood begins mass producing uniforms. Okay, अगर large production है तो क्या होगा process costing because everything is going on the same process. ठीक है A job order system would not be adequate for the costing in a mass production environment. When producing large quantities of a mass produced homogeneous product, The appropriate costing system is a process costing. The change Rosewood business would completely change its costing system. Okay? Uska costing system bhi change ho jayega. For 431, calculate the cost per unit by using full absorption costing. Show your calculations. Okay? Sabse pehle cheez bahut simple tha kyunki aapko har ek cost malum tha. Beginning ka cost malum hai. Direct material tha, direct labor aapko bana ke diya tha, 7000 hours lagne wala hai. 1000 आवर्स मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 7 क्योंकि उसने जुलाई में सिर्फ 1000 आवर्स ही लिया था मैन्युफैक्चरिंग ओवरहेड्स मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 3 बिकॉज ये एब्जॉर्प्शन रेट आपको बना के दिया था दिस दे हैव गिवन एब्जॉर्प्शन रेट सो टोटल यू आर गेटिंग 46000 ओके सो 46000 डिवाइड बाय 2000 यूनिट्स व्हिच यू हैड मेड 23 पर यूनिट ठीक है चलो नेक्स्ट Identify and explain the major difference between full and absorption and direct costing. Homework. Define the concept of learning curve. Bahut simple question pucha isne. Learning curve is a mathematical expression of a phenomena that incremental unit cost to produce decrease managerial labor gain experience from the practice and its better method for developed. Okay. Ye kitna simple tha ye. सबसे पहले तुमको बोला था कि 2000 आवर्स लगेगा क्या देखना 2000 फॉर द फर्स्ट यूनिट तो 1, 2, 4, 4000, 8000 आई हैव टॉट यू दैट दिस इज समथिंग कॉल्ड एज बोलो समथिंग कॉल्ड एज व्हाट डबलिंग अप्रोच 3500 नाउ 2 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 3500 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 80% Whatever you are getting, so 2 multiplied by 3500 multiplied by 80%, so this is 5600. 5600 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 80%, how much you are getting? So you will get 5600 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 80%, you will get 8960. Okay. And if you take average, that is 3000 average per unit, so 3500 divided by 2000, you will get 1.75, which is this. Okay, 5600 divided by 4000, you will get 1.4. Okay, so now if you double this also, you will get the same answer. Okay, example 1.75 multiplied by 80%, you will get 1.4. 1.4 multiplied by 80%, you will get 1.12. It's the same, whatever we have learned. ठीक है चलो ये तो लर्निंग कर्व का भी जो क्वेश्चन था वो भी हो गया सिक्स्थ भी हो गया ओह खत्म चलो तीन क्वेश्चन क्या पूछा उसने आफ्टर कंप्लीटिंग 8000 यूनिफॉर्म्स व्हाट इज द एस्टिमेटेड डायरेक्ट लेबर कॉस्ट पर यूनिफॉर्म डायरेक्ट लेबर कॉस्ट उसने पूछा ओके मेरा टोटल आया था ओके उसने स्टार्टिंग का पूछा लास्ट 4000 का पूछा है, मतलब ये सो नेचुरल सी बात है, दिस माइनस दिस यू विल गेट 4000, ओके सो 3360 यूनिट्स। अब सर ये क्या हो रहा है, अरे बॉस 3360 ही आएगा ना फॉर नेक्स्ट 4000 यूनिट्स। तुम लोग बोलेगा सर ऊपर का ही लिख रहा है, अरे भाई वो कैलकुलेशन भी वही है ना, 4 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 7 आवर्स विच इज $5.88 डायरेक्ट लेबर। ठीक है, नाउ केस नंबर 21, हॉल्ट मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इज जस्ट कंप्लीटेड इट्स फर्स्ट ईयर ऑफ ऑपरेशन, हॉल्ट प्रोड्यूसेस अ न्यू टाइप ऑफ कंप्यूटर एसेसरी फॉर द स्टोरिंग एंड चार्जिंग लैपटॉप्स कंप्यूटर। Planning the production levels from the month to month in this business has been challenge. Managers and the sales associate are making new business contract and securing order. But sales each level month can vary. Har month different ho sakta. The company located in the state of Indiana in the US and currently only sells to the small retailers in the Midwestern part of US. The company's sales force is working to identify new sales opportunities in the areas outside the Midwest. Sidney Wrights is a sales manager of Holt Manufacturing. Wrights believe that projections for the sales to increase over the next 2 or 4 years are accurate based on the planned expansion of the company's sales market. Oliver Rander is a production manager for the business. Rander is struggling to prepare production forecast based on the volatile sales level in the business. Production levels are determined using forecast sales data. अभी ये क्या क्या है? ज़रा ध्यान से देखता है। Sales दिया है। Following is a summary of a result of a halt first year operation. Sales. Unadjusted cost of goods sold, selling and admin expenses, ending balance of the inventory account shown below, raw material, work in progress, finished goods. Okay. Holt estimated overhead at the beginning of the year is 3 lakhs. Estimated overhead. Overhead is assigned based on machine hours which are estimated to 48,000 in a year. Actual machine hours were 41,000. Actual overhead incurred this year was 2,60,000. जितना डिटेल चाहिए सब कुछ दिया है उसमें, ओके। फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन दे आर आस्किंग, कैलकुलेट द अमाउंट ऑफ हॉल्ट्स अंडर अप्लाइड एंड द ओवर अप्लाइड ओवरहेड, शो योर कैलकुलेशन, हाउ यू आर गोइंग टू डू दिस, ओके। सबसे पहली बात, मैंने आपको बोला था जब भी ऐसा कुछ आए मेक वन टेबल ओवरहेड्स, यहाँ पे क्या आएगा, टू कैश बैंक, हाउ मच यू हैड इनकर्ड, 2,60,000, ओके। What is your absorption rate? First, you need to calculate absorption rate. How you will calculate? Estimation overheads divide by level of activity. Level of activity is 48,000. Okay. 3 lakh divided by 48,000. This will be 6.25. Okay. How much hours you had actually used? So you will say 41,000. So 41,000 multiplied by 6.25. चलो तो क्या आता है, 2,60,375. नाउ यू विल टेल मी वेदर इट इज अंडर एब्जॉर्प्शन और ओवर एब्जॉर्प्शन। नेचुरली इफ हियर इज कमिंग इट इज अंडर एब्जॉर्प्शन, तुमने खर्चा किया 260 बट यू आर ओनली एब्जॉर्बिंग 256,250, ओके। सो लेट्स चेक वेदर our answer is coming or not. Ye le 3750 under applied, okay. Next 2, chalo identify and describe two different methods Holt could use to allocate this under and over applied overhead at the end of the year. Bahut acche se maine tumko padhaya, material hai to cost of goods sold, नॉन मटेरियल है तो क्या करने का, इन्वेंट्री पर डाल दो, ठीक है, ये मैंने सब पढ़ा है अच्छे से। चलो The two methods for the allocating balance of manufacturing overhead on the pro rata, also known as proportion, and the writing off directly to the cost of goods sold. Under proportion or the under or over allocated overhead is allocated between ending balances of work in progress inventory, finished goods inventory and costs of goods sold on a pro rata basis. ये कभी करने का जब तुम्हारा material variances बहुत ज़्यादा है, then you need to allocate proportionately. Final balance of manufacturing overhead is zero after the entire amount is transferred to proportionately to these accounts. एक बार भेज देगा तो naturally balance tally हो जाएगा. Note, you do not include raw material in the allocation since no overhead is assigned to raw material inventory. एक बात बता, raw material तो freshly include होता है ना, तुम उसमें कहाँ पे डाल सकते हैं? Under writing of cost of goods sold method, the total of the under or overhead all transfer to cost of goods sold. कभी जब तुम्हारा balances non-material हो, ये भी मैंने तुमको पढ़ाया, non-material है, ठीक है? चलो, third, sorry, question तो क्या है भाई, question तो देख ले. Identify and explain the most appropriate method to allocate this under and over applied or the over applied overhead in this situation. Second question पूछा है, उसका ही answer फिर से third में पूछता है. काम पे डालोगे, मैं आगे कुछ नहीं पढ़ने वाला हूँ, ये भी तुम्हारा homework ही है. उसको या तो proportionally बांटो या तो halt should allocate, मैं तो इतना ही लिखता हूँ, halt should allocate the under applied overheads directly to the cost of goods sold. Relatively small amount compared to size of operation. The company maintains relatively small levels of inventory compared to cost of goods sold. Work in progress halt should allocate under applied overheads directly to the cost of goods sold. Why? Because it is non-material difference. Non-material difference. ठीक है? चलो. Fourth. Identify and explain the impact that under and applied and over applied overhead on a HOT's profitability for the year. अगर कभी भी तुम्हारा under applied आता ना तो तुम्हारा expenditure बढ़ जाता, ठीक है? So naturally profit पे थोड़ा सा impact आता, ठीक है? Example थोड़ा यहाँ पे दिखते हैं. पहले cost of goods sold कितना था? जरा यहाँ पे notice करना. 97,970. लेकिन यहाँ पे इफ यू नोटिस यहाँ पे इंक्रीज हो गया बिकॉज 9,70,000 प्लस 3,750 भी तो आया. अरे समझा, करेक्ट ना? और सेलिंग डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन तो सेम ही है. उसके वजह से क्या हुआ, तुम्हारा जो प्रॉफिट था वो लॉस में कन्वर्ट हो गया. होप यू अंडरस्टैंडिंग दिस, ठीक है? प्लीज इसको रीड करना, समझेगा अच्छे से. Fifth, explain how activity-based costing might help in HALT in future years. Okay, six भी ऐसे ही create कर लेते हैं. What type of budgeting could HALT use to monitor the performance? Activity-based costing बोल रहा है, क्या help करेगा? Activity-based costing, ABC refines a costing system by identifying individual activities as a fundamental cost object. Hydrogen 146. HALT would able to identify cost object and the various cost pool of the overheads. ये तुमको पता ही होगा, ये ABC का basics है. Using ABC, HALT could refine and improve their cost analysis by using different cost pools and the different cost drivers for the various overhead activities. ABC cost drivers have a better cause and effect relationship with the cost in the cost pool. HALT 154. ABC provides a more accurate costing, will provide better information in decision making. The cost benefit ABC should be considered as a cost of implementing such system can be significant. If machine hours truly drive most of the overhead cost or the HALT produces only one product, ABC might not be beneficial. Agar ek hi product banayega to ABC costing kya karega? Sabka to driver usko mil hi jayega. Theek hai? So now he is asking कि कौन सा बजट यूज करने का. नॉर्मली इफ यू वॉन्ट टू कंपेयर द परफॉर्मेंस, फ्लेक्सिबल बजट इज द बेस्ट बजटिंग सिस्टम. ओके, द की टू मॉनिटरिंग द बिजनेस परफॉर्मेंस विद द बजट्स विल बी यूज फ्लेक्सिबल बजटिंग as activity levels could be changed, vary from the original master budget plans. HALT should use flexible budgeting to compare actual result with the budgeted based on production, actual production level same hona chahiye, comparable. Managers can use the flexible budget as a part of a planning process to predict how budget will change under various scenarios, such as worst case or best case scenario. They can also use flexible budget as a benchmark for evaluating performance after the fact, or as a part of control process. Mark this question as very important. Thoda unique tha. Okay, please mark it, very important. Now we will learn case number 22. Let me check first whether you all can do this or not. This is homework. I'll tease this. Chalo. I'll only teach 1 to 4. Theek hai? Chalo, let's start. I'm just going to discuss 1 to 4 with you. Case number 22. Arcan Production is upgrading its manufacturing process from a manual process to the highly automated system. Management believes that a new system will result in greater efficiencies and a better finished product. Arcan is also working on a plan to downsize staff after the implementation of a new system. Arcan has used a traditional absorption costing system to calculate unit product cost for the external financial reporting. In the past, Arcan has allocated manufacturing overhead cost using predetermined plant-wise overhead rate based on direct labor hours. The controller realized that new system may require changing overhead allocation process. Management plans to take opportunity to consider the other improvements in the costing system. पहली चीज़ तो highly automated system आया, ठीक है? तो तुम labor hours लेके तुम कुछ कर नहीं पाओगे, ठीक है? Identify and explain three disadvantages of using predetermined plant-wide overhead rate to allocate overhead cost. Mark this question, also important. Why not to use plant-wise overhead rate? Please highlight with this. Huh? A plant-wide allocation system may work well for some companies, but may end up distorting product cost if the different department incurs different amount of manufacturing overhead, or that if different products use department to the different extent, different department producing different products. Okay, when either of the both this condition exist, the plant wide overhead rate will likely to distort production cost, because kis pe kya allocate hoga kuch samajh mein nahi aayega. Allocating higher than actual cost to the department that do not incur certain cost, and the higher than actual cost to the product do not use the all department part of production, it usually does not provide valuable information to the cost control improvement of the internal control. Most important statement. नेचुरल सी बात है, जिसका जिसमें कॉस्ट अलोकेट होना चाहिए था उतना कॉस्ट उसमें अलोकेट ही नहीं होता है. किसी एक बंदे ने वो चीज़ यूज़ ही नहीं किया, तुम उसको अलोकेट कर रहा है, तो नेचुरली उसके प्रोडक्ट का प्राइस ज़्यादा ही दिखेगा. इट कैन हार्डली मोटिवेट डिपार्टमेंट मैनेजर्स टू अचीव गोल्स ऑफ द टॉप मैनेजमेंट देन फेयरली डिटरमाइन द रिवॉर्ड्स अर्न बाय द मैनेजर्स. चलो, टू, आइडेंटिफाई एंड एक्सप्लेन थ्री बेनिफिट्स ऑफ यूजिंग डिपार्टमेंटल ओवरहेड रेट्स to allocate overhead cost. Uska hi opposite hoga, same to same. Why we should be using department overhead rate? Natural si baat hai, jo product jo department banata hai uska cost uske upar allocate kar do. A departmental overhead rate does a better job matching each department overhead cost to the product that department's resource, jitna resource use kiya utna cost allocate hua. It provides more valuable information to the cost control and improvements of the internal control. It also provides the right incentive for the managers to make decisions that are consistent with the top management and evaluate their performance fairly. Good point. मैं नहीं बताता तो भी तुमको याद आता समझ में. Explain why direct labor may not be good basis for the allocating overhead cost after Alcan implement the new system. Because labor to use in Yoda, it is fully automated system. The old manufacturing system was a highly manual and direct labor were directly related to the actual work put into product. Since new system is automated, there will be significantly less direct labor and the hours may not reflect true cost of the product. Last question for this. Recommend two bases for the overhead allocation rather than direct labor cost might work better in new manufacturing process. मैं होता तो मैं बोलता machines. Okay, देखिए यहाँ पे उसने बोला भी है. May be good base for the allocation if throughput units departmental resource equally may be a good base. अगर तुमको लगता है सब machines से ही काम चल रहा है, then you can easily allocate this. Okay, guys, this I had completed section D. All the best. Next, I will be coming with section E in the next video.